Hello and welcome to this tutorial on installing and configuring LangFlow. In this video, we're going to be looking at the different installation methods for LangFlow. Now, LangFlow can be installed in three primary ways. I say primary because there are other ways or other means to deploy LangFlow on different websites to still get access to it. But these are the three fundamental ways. So you can install it as a Python package with LangFlow OSS, a standalone desktop application with LangFlow Desktop, and as a cloud-hosted service with DataStax LangFlow. Now here you see that LangFlow Desktop is available for macOS, and you can click on Try the Alpha version. With this, all you need to do to get LangFlow Desktop is click Download Alpha, and remember that this is only available for macOS users. When you click this, you'll see a form asking for your name, email address, your company, and then you click Download. Then you open your file explorer, navigate to downloads, and double-click the .dmg file. Basically, to install LangFlow Desktop, you drag and drop the application icon to the applications folder. And when the installation completes, you open your LangFlow application. Then also we have DataStax LangFlow, which is a hosted version of LangFlow integrated with AstraDB. You'll be up and running in minutes with no installation or setup required. So with this, now let's go back here. So with DataStax LangFlow, you just click Get Started for Free, and then you can sign up with your Google account or your GitHub account. You select LangFlow under DataStax. After that, you accept the terms and policies, and now you're up and running with your LangFlow, your DataStax LangFlow. However, there's another way to do this. You can do it in a terminal. All right, so in the terminal here, you can use pip install LangFlow to install LangFlow OSS. Now, after you use the pip install LangFlow command, you can run LangFlow once you're done using Python's install manager to install LangFlow. Once you're done doing this, you can run it with LangFlow run. However, this has many dependencies, and you have to install some dependencies prior to this. There's another way to actually install or run LangFlow locally. That's by using the Docker image to create a Docker container that will host your LangFlow locally. A Docker image simply bundles together all the necessary components for an application, including the code, runtime environment, libraries, dependencies, etc. Now, to use Docker, you run the -p flag with the port mapping 7860, and then you use the image langflow-ai.langflow:latest. So this line of code, or this command, is actually going to create a container where you can run your LangFlow locally. Then I just hit enter, and you see here that the LangFlow image does not exist locally, so it pulls from the Docker registry. Now the LangFlow container has been created. Remember, for this you have to have your Docker engine running, so you have to have your Docker engine running before you can create this container from the Docker image. You see the image here, and you see the container name here. You see the ports. And now if you open your browser, you'll see that LangFlow is running locally on your desktop at localhost 7860. So you see that here we have the same interface. These are the various ways by which you can access LangFlow. Of course, you can still deploy LangFlow on Render. You can deploy it on Fly or on different websites as you may please. In our next video, we're going to be looking at the basic overview of the LangFlow interface and how to then create flows subsequently. So thank you for being part of this. I'll see you in the next video.